Hello YouTube. In today's video we're going to continue blending the back of the Magwell that I installed in the previous video. I think I mentioned in my previous video that what I did was I put the grip panels on and then traced the contour on the inside here, showing me basically the shape of the grips. And so I'm getting to that line as I'm reducing these corners. But also you can probably see some marker basically on the mainspring housing. I was thinking about doing semi-round butt, almost bobtail on it, and I think I'm going to go for it. So I'm going to actually reduce this edge, the very top edge as well. Currently, the mainspring housing protrudes out of the frame on the sides, and because I want to treat my mainspring housing as part of the rear strap, I want to create a continuous strap, basically. Right now we're going to start checkering. I'll start with the vertical lines first. Oh, and the other thing to mention is I've decided to extend the chamfer in the back, kind of like a bobtail, kind of like a round butt, obviously not as much as either, maybe actually more than round butt, but not as much as bobtail. So we're going to start checkering here. The process is exactly the same as I showed before for the front strap checkering. Now I'm going to start cutting the horizontal lines. Before that, I'm just going to do another pass of the verticals. Now we'll start deepening them. Now I'm going to go through and actually with a 90 degree file start bringing the horizontals to a point, to a sharp point on top. Now I'm going to be cutting vertical lines, and as you can see, I got pretty lucky. I almost positioned my checkering in the center enough to where the last line that I want to cut vertically is going to be right in the seam between mainspring housing and frame. By the way, I'm using a 60 degree file for now, because now I know what the depth is as dictated by the horizontal lines.